Mathematics is sometimes a difficult subject for many students. In particular, in Southeast Asian countries, our students have found the learning of mathematics difficult. In the 1960s, 1970s, even in the 1980s, education systems in Southeast Asia had not been able to help our students learn mathematics well. In the 1960s, education systems in East Asian countries, for example, Japan, Korea, their average learners were at least 1 year above expectation. To help us make sense of the numbers, 500 suggests students are learning at an adequate level, and a difference of about 40 points suggests 1 year of learning. So in the early years, for example, in the Japanese system, their average learners were in the 500s, scoring at about 550, which is about 1 year above expectation. On the other hand, in Southeast Asia, our students are scoring in the 400s, typically about 450. 450 would suggest one school year below expectation. So you can imagine, if the average learner is already 1 year below expectation, you can imagine that that system is not helping their students learn mathematics at an adequate level. Just like all the other Southeast Asian countries, Thailand, Malaysia, the Philippines, Indonesia, Singaporean students were also not doing well in the earlier days. The three reasons why our students have not been able to do well in mathematics. First, rote memorization. When students are expected to memorize in a rote fashion, their mathematics learning suffers. Second, procedures without understanding. When students do not understand the procedures that they can execute, that can sabotage the learning of mathematics. Third, tedious computation. When students are expected to do tedious computation, that's when mathematics learning becomes a chore, a burden, not interesting. These are the three things that today we know can cause low-level learning in mathematics. Many students in Southeast Asia, even in Singapore in the earlier years, were expected to learn mathematics by rote memorizing, doing procedures that they do not understand, also quite a lot of tedious calculation by hand. And those things have made their performance in mathematics not very good. But are there ways we can help students? Thankfully, the answer is yes. Mathematical ability is negligibly genetic and predominantly opportunities. When we provide students with the right opportunities, they can learn mathematics at a pretty high level. What are the learning experiences that teachers can provide students with? According to research and learning theories, there are six such learning experiences. First, exploration. Students should begin their learning through exploration before structured learning, and afterwards, practice to consolidate whatever they have learned. Those are three of the six learning experiences: exploration, structured learning, and practice. That's based on a theory by Deans. Other learning experiences include the fact that mathematics is a language, hence the need for reading and writing. Mathematics learning needs to include those learning experiences. So many teachers in Singapore schools provide students with the opportunity to engage with journal writing. Finally, the learning experience of reflection, a theory by Dewey, reminds us that reflection is the main mechanism we use to convert all the information that we get into knowledge that we own. So there are ways we can help students learn mathematics at a high level. Using research and learning theories, we can do that by providing suitable learning experiences for our students. Hopefully, part of the learning is also done in a collaborative setting. Vygotsky reminds us collaboration and interaction are important components in learning of mathematics. We cannot learn mathematics sitting all by ourselves in isolation. Learning, including the learning of mathematics, is a social activity. And the use of language, the use of conversation, that is part of the theory by Piaget. Those are the ways we can help to move students from low-level learning to high-level learning. Choosing the right tools. That is an important part of our work as a teacher. When I want students to learn a lesson in geometry, I can use tools such as a software for them to explore. The values of angle subtended. If I fix 2 points, I can see the various angles that subtended at the circumference of the circle. And the software takes the tedium out of the act of drawing, measuring using protractor, which is not very accurate in any case. So use of software such as that allow students to get to the idea much quicker. Such exploration with the use of a software can move the learning of students, can accelerate the learning opportunities. So choosing the right tool. Likewise, I can imagine in a lesson on probability, I might get students to roll a dice or to toss a coin. The practical experience is necessary. But after a while, we also want them to be able to generalize and extend their initial observation into something more abstract. And the use of a scientific calculator will allow them to toss a coin or roll a dice. While the initial practical experience is necessary, the use of a technological tool, for example, a scientific calculator to extend students' learning and thinking, is also necessary. Choosing the right tools. Sometimes practical experience, and other times, the use of a technological tool.